Hello, everybody, wherever you are. I'm Peter Matheson, the principal of the University of Edinburgh. Wherever you are, for this year's welcome to the university, those words are particularly apposite. We would normally expect McEwen Hall to be full with new students, whether undergraduate or postgraduate, whether students from Scotland, from the rest of the UK or international, and we would be joined by some online students starting one of our distance learning courses. This year, you are all online, at least at the moment, and I am here in an empty McEwen Hall. Some of you will already be in Edinburgh. To you, welcome to one of the world's great cities. To those of you that have, for whatever reason, not yet managed to get here, please feel part of the University of Edinburgh's wonderful community of scholars, about 40,000 current students, over 15,000 staff, and over 260,000 alumni all over the world. You are the latest to join this magnificent group, and you're all most welcome. For 437 years, this university has been providing excellence in teaching, research, knowledge exchange, social and civic responsibility. The past few months must rank as one of the most extraordinary periods in the university's long history, and indeed in all of our lives. However, nothing can take away from the superb opportunity that you have earned for yourselves to join one of the world's great universities. In due course, you will graduate, hopefully here in McEwen Hall, as an Edinburgh degree holder to follow in the footsteps of intellectual, sporting and societal giants of previous cohorts. On behalf of all students and staff at the University of Edinburgh, huge congratulations on your success in getting into our university. The competition is tough. The extraordinary circumstances of 2020, as the world adapts to the COVID-19 pandemic, have posed additional challenges to you and to us. But we remain very confident that your success in joining one of the world's greatest universities will be the start of an exciting and productive next phase of your lives. For you, arriving at university at this time, the only thing that is certain is that there will be uncertainty. The world is battling a dangerous and unpredictable virus. We must balance the health and safety of all members of the university community and of the wider public with our desire to provide you with the best possible experience that the University of Edinburgh and the City of Edinburgh, capital of Scotland, and a hugely historic and beautiful location, can offer. We have described our teaching and learning provision for your first semester as hybrid. What we mean by this is a mixture of face-to-face and online interactions with your teachers and with others, including your fellow students, with the precise proportions of each being adjusted according to the prevailing public health situation of the time. I cannot predict even a few days ahead what that will be, let alone a few months. But I can assure you that we will strive to provide you with the best opportunities within whatever difficult circumstances we have to face, and that your Edinburgh degree will be every bit as valuable as Edinburgh degrees have been for over four centuries. In fact, this pandemic is not the first to challenge the University of Edinburgh. Early on in the pandemic, I was reminded by Jean Greer, a brilliant historian of the university as well as a current member of our staff, that in the 16th century, epidemics of the plague caused the university to close several times, and no new students were admitted in 1585, just 2 years after the university's establishment, for that reason. The University of Edinburgh survived and flourished then, and it will survive and flourish now. You will contribute to that flourishing. Successive new cohorts of students bring new lifeblood to our university, renewing the energy, enthusiasm, and potential on which we thrive. It'll be both exciting and daunting for you. We will support you and care for you, but we will also give you space to develop and to make your own way. For many of you, this will be the first time that you've lived away from home. Edinburgh is your new home, even if you've not physically been able to get here yet. Please remember that you each have a responsibility to care for the others. If you become aware of someone feeling isolated, lonely, or worried, talk to them, whether digitally or via phone, social media, or email, or face-to-face. Care about them and help them to seek support if they need it. It is never a sign of weakness to ask for help. It is a sign of strength to recognize that you need it. You will hear today from Professor Devi Sridhar, one of our brilliant experts who's been advising governments and others about the pandemic and our responses to it. The University of Edinburgh has made, and indeed is still making, magnificent contributions to the understanding and management of the pandemic. Difficult and controversial topics like the role of testing, face masks, social distancing, etc., as well as research on drugs to treat the disease, genetic and other studies to understand why some people are much more severely affected than others, and detailed studies of the economic and social consequences of the pandemic, which threaten to be even more serious for the world than the direct medical impacts themselves. I'm very proud of the many ways in which the University of Edinburgh has responded and adapted to the pandemic, never losing sight of our central mission to make the world a better place. So, welcome again. No matter what your background, previous experience, nationality, ethnicity, race, sexual orientation, physical ability, or any other characteristic, you are welcome here, and we will respect you as a member of our community. You must respect others very different from yourselves. That is the ethos of a university community such as ours. Education transforms lives. You have earned yourself a great opportunity. Very well done. Now, make the most of it. Work hard, play hard, be kind to others, and be the best that you can be. This year will be different from previous years. Communications will be more important than ever. You will all be invited, if you haven't already, to join Platform One, our online platform, which will help you to keep in touch with one another, with the university, and with other students, staff, alumni, and friends. I encourage you to use it. I look forward to meeting as many of you as possible during your studies at the University of Edinburgh. Well done so far. This is just the beginning. All strength to you for the next stages. You are going to love it here.
Hi, and a really warm welcome to all of you. It's 26 years since I was where you are right now. And I was ready, I was nervous, I was excited, and I was questioning of my abilities and my right to be there, whether or not I had earned my place. But university really taught me to think, to analyse, and to believe in my place at the table, I suppose. And that's something that I hope you all come away with after this amazing experience that you're about to embark on.
Before I went to Edinburgh, I was really, really nerdy. And I was really nervous because I have never been overseas at all. So my time in Edinburgh has opened many doors for me. Today, I am a much more curious and open-minded person.
For me, I think I am much more open to different opportunities, whether that is learning to tango dance and running the society on campus or making programs for Radio 4. But I think it's really important to remember that as much as you are going to change, the world around you is going to change too.
Edinburgh University gave me a global mindset, but more than that, it gave me the opportunity to live and work in this fantastic city and get involved in everything that an Edinburgh life has to offer. Good luck to you.
I am who I am today because of the way Edinburgh structured its learning, the way that I had the time to explore what I really enjoyed. Really, just take this time to challenge who you are and who you want to be and get yourself there because you can absolutely do it.
I'm glad you've chosen Edinburgh as your academic destination for the next few years, and I wish you all the very best in your studies, your research and life. You're very welcome to a global and outward-looking university.
Principal Matheson, Professor Sirdar, Heads of Department Students, as the Lord Provost of the City of Edinburgh, I've been asked to speak for a few moments to introduce Scotland's historic capital and comment on its success and its recovery. Edinburgh prides itself on being a warm, friendly, welcoming 900-year-old capital city, comprising over 510,000 residents, embracing all cultures, nationalities and faiths, and is home to many political and leading academic institutions. The city historically has and continues to have a substantial international and national impact, influencing key sectors including science, technology, business, architecture, education, engineering, the economy, sports, and indeed the arts. Until recently, our city was a strong economic engine with robust social and environmental credentials, winning much praise around the world as the strongest city economy in the UK outside of London, the best city to live in the world based on its low crime rates, high levels of education and high levels of health amongst its citizens, the UK's top destinations for students to live and study, and home to our world-leading festivals, attractions, and of course our UNESCO World Heritage Centres and Centre of Literature Excellence. In relation to social and environmental considerations, our city is home to over 4,500 charitable and civil society organisations, giving fantastic opportunities for volunteering. We have substantial targets and schemes to reduce air carbon, increase recycling, and promote active travel through walking and cycling. Against this backdrop and managing the wide-ranging impacts of COVID-19, you come to Scotland's ancient capital, re-emerging from long months of lockdown. Throughout the lockdown, we have seen many positives, with communities coming together, more people giving their time to others, and above all, the profile of our health workers, our carers, our volunteers, and our council workers becoming much higher. Now, as we are all entering the so-called new normal, we have, with Scottish Government guidance, a city-wide phased plan to return our city to its former success. And a key element of this is welcoming back our student cohort to the city. So please enjoy your time studying here. Please enjoy all that our city has to offer. But above all else, keep yourselves and others safe. Thank you.
Welcome to Edinburgh University Students Association, an organisation run for and by students.
Every Edinburgh University student automatically becomes a member of the Students Association, and together we work to support, represent and entertain you.
Your Students Association is run by us, your elected full-time sabbatical officer team.
I'm Ellen, your president.
I'm Rachel, your vice president activities and services.
I'm Amanda, your vice president community.
I'm Fizzy, your vice president education.
And I'm Neve, your Vice President Welfare.
We know that the last few months have been far from what you could have expected.
Whether you've been finishing school remotely or taking your exams online, it has been difficult, isolating and uncertain.
That's why we've been working over summer to ensure that whether you're joining us on campus or from afar, you're welcomed in true Students Association style.
Our key services are here for you.
Your advice place offers free and impartial advice on areas such as your finances, academic concerns and accommodation. Give them a call, send them an email, or check out their advice online.
Get academic support from other students through our peer learning and support scheme, and improve your CV through our volunteering service. Put your business ideas into action with social enterprises and make the most of the global community at Edinburgh with the Global Students Programme.
Your student representatives are here for you.
Liberation officers are working to ensure that marginalised student voices are heard.
Section reps are here to support student groups that are underrepresented in higher education.
And over 1,600 programme reps are working to improve the teaching, feedback, spaces and services you have access to.
Student Council is here to ensure that you always have the power to make a change at your Students Association.
Your societies and student groups are here for you.
From charities, social causes, entertainment, and those that serve an academic purpose, there really is something for everyone.
Join a society or student group to make new friends, give something new a go, or rediscover your passion.
No Excuse is here to create a better and safer university experience for you by encouraging us all to take collective responsibility for ending sexual violence and harassment on campus.
Our Black Lives Matter pledge is here to ensure that everyone gets the university experience they deserve.
Your Students Association is here to help you live your best green life.
Read our green guide for tips and tricks on how to be green on a student budget, visit our zero waste shop when it reopens, and look forward to eco events and activities.
Potter Row, TV at Row House, The Pleasance, and King's Buildings House are here for you.
We look forward to welcoming you to your venues for a tasty lunch, a quick coffee, a cheeky cocktail, or a cold pint.
When we're able to do so, we can't wait to entertain you at our Big Cheese Club night, weekly quizzes, LGBT plus club nights, live music sets and more.
Check out our Facebook What's On channel or check the event listings on our website to find out more.
These times have been uncertain and they continue to be so.
However, you are now part of one of the largest student communities in the country. So no matter what comes next, we will tackle it together.
We are Edinburgh University Students Association and now you are too.
Welcome!
Hi everyone, my name's Ellen and I am your Students Association President. And on behalf of the Students Association, I am delighted to welcome you to the University of Edinburgh. Whether you'll be joining us on one of our campuses or solely online, you are now part of this university, the student community, and this city. Edinburgh has always prided itself on being an international university, and now, more than ever, we are globally connected. We're connected through our studies, through our research, and through our relationships with each other. These past few months have been challenging, but the way in which we have all adapted and overcome adversity has been extraordinary and gives me great hope in our collective future. As a student during these unprecedented times, your resilience is a true strength and a credit to you. And knowing some of the challenges that many of you will have overcome just to be here today gives me confidence that you will achieve great things during your time here at Edinburgh and beyond. While we've all been drawn to Edinburgh by a desire to grow and challenge ourselves academically, having just finished my own degree, I can promise you that being a student here is so much more than what happens in your tutorials and your lectures. The people you get to meet, the events you get to enjoy, and the community that you'll be a member of for life will truly enrich and enhance your time here. And whilst life as a student may look different from how you imagined when you first applied, there are still so many opportunities and experiences now available to you, which will shape you as an individual and have a lasting impact on you both personally and professionally. From societies to peer learning and support schemes, volunteering groups, social enterprises, and our Global Buddies program, your Students' Association is committed to creating spaces where you can learn new skills, meet like-minded people, and make a difference. No matter where you are, where you're from, your identity, your ethnicity, your sexuality, your religion, or your gender, your Students' Association is here for you, and there is something for everyone. We are here to connect you to those people who will be friends for life, here to help you on those days where it does feel harder, and we are here to help you grow into the graduate you want to be. Our diversity as a community is our strength. We've all arrived at this moment uniquely shaped by our experiences, our backgrounds and our identities, all giving us a unique perspective on the world around us. Never before has it been more important that we acknowledge and celebrate these differences, listen to the experiences of others, and be open to learning and growing together. Today is just the start of our journey together, and whilst I'm sure some of you might be feeling overwhelmed or uncertain about the future, I hope you're also excited to be taking these next steps with myself and your Students' Association by your side. We've got your back from your first day at Edinburgh until your last. So get in touch, get involved, join that group, get creative, have fun, and welcome to the University of Edinburgh.
Hello everyone, my name is Katie McDonald and I'm the Sports Union President. 8,000 students, 160 intramural teams and 64 sports clubs. With sports ranging from archery and athletics to wakeboard and water ski, we really do have something for everyone studying here at Edinburgh. Whether you've been active since starting school or you're brand new to any one of our sports, our clubs are always looking to welcome new members, supported by our dedicated staff team, 270 registered coaches, and countless volunteers. For those looking to be involved in physical activity with less of a time commitment, our intramural programme continues to go from strength to strength. You can enter a team with those in your university accommodation, or perhaps those you meet on your course, competing against others within the university. An absolutely fantastic way to get to know people outside of the classroom. For those athletes competing at national or international levels, our performance programme staff and coaches will help you to continue to strive for excellence. Our world-class facilities here at Edinburgh are open to all. They include state-of-the-art outdoor pitches at Peffermill Playing Fields, including our recently relayed 3G surface, as well as an incredible free weights and cardio repertoire at Pleasant Sports Centre. They also include a swimming pool at St Leonard's Land, in addition to a satellite gym based out at the Easterbush campus. Alongside our sporting offering, we continue to improve the programmes offered by our coaching and volunteering academy. Through lectures, workshops and funding support, our volunteers are always looking to build on their skill sets and improve their employability during their time with us. I know many of you will be anxious about beginning your university careers during this uncertain time. We as a sports union want to continue to cater for all students to have the best experience possible. Your wellbeing is the university's number one priority, and I strongly believe that we as a sports union can help provide a positive environment and a solid support system around you during your time with us. The memories I made on the football pitch with my teammates will stay with me forever and have given me some absolutely incredible lifelong friends. These are the experiences which shaped my time at university, and I wholeheartedly hope that you experience the same. Our students are incredibly excited to welcome you to Edinburgh, whether that be in person or virtually. Please join us at any of our events during Welcome Week, where you can learn more about our 64 sports clubs and the facilities that we have on offer. Whether you're joining us for 1 year, 4 years, or even longer, your time as an Edinburgh student will absolutely fly by. My advice would be to enjoy every second, take advantage of all the incredible opportunities which come your way, and to work as hard as you can. Good luck with your journeys, and remember, we are Edinburgh.
Hi, and welcome, students, wherever you might be studying. My name is Professor Devi Sridhar, and I'm at the University of Edinburgh Medical School. I'm going to be taking off my mask because I'm 2 meters away from anyone else. And this is just a reminder that we're trying to keep the university as safe and as welcoming as possible for all students. And that means making sure you have a face covering when you're inside, when you're unable to distance, and this means public transport, shops, as well as libraries and lecture theatres. Edinburgh is a fantastic city, and the Scottish Government is doing its utmost to make it as safe and as normal as possible. But this also involves certain measures. It means for each of you avoiding crowded places. If you see a beach or a pub or a library that's just too busy, find another one. The great thing about Scotland is there's plenty of space to find other places to enjoy yourself. The next thing is actually to wash your hands, make sure you're disinfecting surfaces such as your mobile phones or things that you might be touching frequently to make sure you're not passing on the virus to others. Also, if you're feeling unwell, if you have a fever or a cough or a loss of taste or smell, to just get tested. There'll hopefully be sites nearby where you can just pop by, make sure that you're not infected yourself and that you're not exposing yourself to others. And it'll be great if you can comply with contact tracers if they do contact you, to let them know where you've been so we can follow up and make sure that everyone who could have been exposed gets quickly into isolation. And that's an important piece as well, making sure that if you are asked to isolate or if you're coming from a higher prevalence country into Scotland, that you make sure you abide by that so we can keep things as normal and as safe as possible for Edinburgh. Edinburgh is a fantastic city. It's international, it's dynamic. There's parks, there's beaches, plenty of things to do outside. So I'd highly recommend you get outdoors and enjoy all that the city has to offer, as well as even if it's raining, putting on some warm jackets and hats and getting out all the same. So welcome, and we're really delighted to have you all here and studying with us either in Edinburgh or wherever you might be across the world.
Oh,